Good afternoon, everybody. As you've probably realized by now, hopefully realized by now, that I am not here today. So I'm just going to introduce class, and then you're going to have a work day for most of the day. You can work by yourself or in a small group. And today we're going to explore almost the exact opposite flavor of Christianity than what we explored last time. And so what we're listening to now is a Nicaraguan song which reimagines Jesus Christ's life into modern-day Nicaragua. And we'll listen to two verses and a chorus, and you could follow along with the lyrics on the screen.
Las gentes para mirarlo se rejuntaron en un molote. El indio Joaquín le trajo quesillo en trenza de nagarote. En vez de oro, incienso y mirra le regalaron, según yo supe, cajetitas de tiriomo y hasta buñuelos de Guadalupe.
Cristo ya nació en Palacabina de Chepe, Pavón, Pavón. Y una tal María, ella va a planchar muy humildemente la ropa que goza la mujer hermosa del terrateniente.
El pobre jornalero se me catella todito el día. Lo tiene con reumatismo el tequio de la carpintería. María sueña que el hijo, igual que el tata, sea carpintero. Pero el cipotillo piensa, mañana quiero ser guerrillero.
Cristo ya nació en
Palacio. And so, as we've been saying, the Christ of faith is infinitely malleable. And we can see how he's malleable here, with a Marxist take on the Last Supper, or this Argentinian take of the Stations of the Cross, reimagining Jesus in an industrial Argentinian context, where he's now an exploited worker. Feel free to Google that name on the bottom to see the rest of those. Or Google Latin Liberation Jesus, where you'll see both a Jesus of peace and a Jesus of violence. And so that brings us to our burning question for the day. What political and social context did the social gospel arise out of? And then what about a liberation theology? A lot of what we looked at so far would be categorized under liberation theology, which one could argue is a piece of the social gospel flavor of Christianity. And so I'll explain more of this in a second, but today you'll have an opportunity to earn some extra credit. There'll be a couple readings, you'll do an ed puzzle. And your only homework would be to finish what you don't get done or to dive into some of the extra credit. I'll be back in class on Ash Wednesday when we'll go over a more restrictive or exclusive morality, and then we'll finish up the week by covering an inclusive morality. And so a quick review of last class when we studied the prosperity gospel with preachers like Joel Osteen or the Copelands. We also saw John Oliver open his own church, Our Lady of Perpetual Exemption. And the prosperity gospel is this idea that God wants people to be more prosperous and he rewards those who are pious, which could then even be taken further to say if you give your money to God or give your money to a church, then God will bless you with more money. And so we've seen how this can create peace and motivation, but also how this could be violent and create exploitation. And so as I said earlier, today is almost the exact opposite form of Christianity. And so remember, we're doing the academic study of religion here, and so throughout this unit, you're going to find things that are going to agree or disagree with your morality, or even your Christianity, if that's what you subscribe to. And that's totally okay. You don't need to deny those feelings, but they shouldn't be driving what we're doing here. We're focused on studying these phenomena, both good and bad, and all in between. So study the power relations, study the cultural peace and violence, the in-group, out-group dynamics. Reflect on your situated perspective and why it's causing you to react in certain ways. And if we keep this focus, we're going to be able to have a lot of interesting and engaging conversations about some tough issues. And so today is all about the social gospel. You guys are going to be doing most of the learning, but let me just introduce you to some bonus extra credit. For your extra credit, you only have to pick one or more of those sources and write a 5+ sentence reflection or summary. If you dive into multiple sources, let me know and I'll include that in your extra credit grade. But you have a Dr. King speech on inequality in America. You have an article about Latin America, Christ, and Marxism. You have that link to the Stations of the Cross that I was showing you earlier, reframing of Jesus in the industrial world. You have a religious for breakfast on why congregations are so divided. And then you have the March to Guadalupe, which is an explanation of a local tradition that many of you might be familiar with, marching to Guadalupe in Des Plaines. But what you're going to be doing today is going through this list of four things. If you just go into Schoology, follow it from top to bottom, you're going to be golden. The first is reading a short article by the Harvard Pluralism Project about the social gospel, and that gives a pretty nice overview of the social and political context of the times. Then afterwards, you're going to read a few verses from the Bible, both Old and New Testament, that offer some biblical justification and legitimization for the social gospel. We'll have you compare and contrast them to the readings we did last time, and just get some general themes. Third, you'll have an Ed puzzle about liberation theology in Nicaragua. And you'll learn some things about the Catholic Church that you might not have known about, specifically how they practiced before the 1960s. Was radically different than how Catholic churches are today. And then finally, you'll read a speech, or possibly two if you decide, about how Dr. King sees the social gospel. Once you're done with those four, you're all good in my book. I'm just realizing now that it didn't have times put on the others, so let me get times there. Hopefully that snap worked. If I accidentally wiped out half of humanity, my bad. I was just trying to teach the kids the gospel. I look forward to seeing your thoughts, and I will see you guys on Wednesday.